When I streamed Xenoblade Chronicles 2 on my YouTube channel, my followers asked me if this game is worth picking up. So I thought I would do a video on this game and show you the graphics, what I think about the game, the gameplay, and everything you need to know, like what I feel like you need to know before you make the decision to buy this game, and if it's worth picking up or stuff like that. So in this video, I am going to show you everything. Let's get started. So Xenoblade Chronicles 2 is a game that was just released for the Nintendo Switch by Nintendo themselves, and it is the third Xenoblade game. The first Xenoblade game that I played was Xenoblade Chronicles 1 for the Wii, and after that I played Xenoblade Chronicles X for the Wii U. Now this is my third one that I have experienced, and I have to say, so far I'm very happy with this game. I got it for Christmas from my man, and I got the collector's edition with the art book and the soundtrack and the steel case. Another thing that I got for Christmas was the Xenoblade Chronicles Pro Controller for the Switch. And this, I have to say, this Pro Controller really was a game changer. Oh god. Well, I am way more comfortable playing on my Nintendo Switch with the actual Pro Controller. Like, up until now, I have used the Joy-Con grip. Like, the Joy-Cons in the Joy-Con grip and stuff. But once you go Pro, you never go back. So I want to tell you guys about the world in Xenoblade Chronicles 2, and that is, the world is basically a cloud sea that you can swim on, and our main character Rex, he makes a living out of salvaging things from the seafloor underneath this cloud ocean. How people live in this world? They live on titans. Titans are huge living beings that smaller creatures and humans are able to live on. But the titans are starting to die out, so there is less and less space, like land, to live on. He says yes to a mercenary job of sorts. Anyway, long story short, he comes in contact with this girl with red hair. Her name is Pyra. She is a blade. Now, a blade is a sort of entity that you use in battle, and you have to be a driver in order to have blades. You can have several blades, kind of like Pokemon, they are your weapons. Like, one blade can be a tank character, melee character, sword, axe, you have your choice there. So, you as a player, you play Rex, and he is a driver. So, when a driver touches something that is called a core crystal, a blade is then formed, and there are a lot of blades to collect in this game. A lot of them are similar and normal type blades, but once you get the rare ones, it's really worth it and so much fun. So can we take a minute to really appreciate the art style in this game? The art style is fantastic. The menus are gorgeous and easy to navigate. Fairly early in the game, you have access to at least three playable characters, and Rex is a kind of DPS sort of class. Now, Tora is a Nopon. Nopon, we know them from earlier Xenoblade games. He is a tank character, so he is the one that is holding all the aggro and gets all the hits. Now, Nia is my favorite character, and I play her a lot. She is a healer character. She has also the most beautiful blade in the entire game so far, from what I have seen. Dromark. So beautiful. There are a lot of like micromanaging things in this game. You have affinity charts, and if you take your time and read everything here, it will start to make sense to you. You have to do certain things with certain blades to improve on them. So basically what this means is that the more you use a certain blade, your favorite blade, let's say, the better things will be for you. On top of that, you can equip aux cores on your blades. They are stat boosting, kind of like equipment. You can make the aux cores and put them together in the shops in each town that you find in the world. So basically, you can play as the role that you are comfortable with. You can fast travel anywhere you have been as long as you have discovered the place. It is called a landmark when you have discovered an important place. That means that you can fast travel there at any time. Another thing, this game has day and night cycle, and I like that a lot because there are different enemies on the fields during the day compared to what it is like in the night. So at any time, you can change the time of day. I really enjoy the camera angles in this game. You have full control. You can tilt the camera up and down and even to the side of the character, kind of, and in and out, of course. And another thing that I found kind of funny is that you can zoom in to the point where you're in a first person perspective. I'm a nerd, so I had a close-up look at everything in first-person mode in the first villages. I could see that a lot of small details are in this game, like small details in the cities, like in the shopping stalls and stuff. I really appreciate all the work that has been put down to this game. This game is looking very beautiful and colorful. I enjoy colorful games. That is what I do with life. More about the blades. They have different element types, but it's not too important to keep track of that. What I find important, so this is like a tip from me, is to look out for the field abilities of each blade. Some blades have a herbalism kind of trait as a field ability, or you will gather more or better minerals, like out and about when you're gathering stuff. So some blades are useful when you're out just to farm and collect stuff. Just read everything within the blades. You can collect blades in the blade album. You can kind of see the silhouettes of the blades that you don't have yet, so a little sneak peek, I guess. So you can try and collect them all. In the towns, every NPC have a star on their dialogue option if they have new dialogue that you haven't read through yet. That is useful. Another thing is that all side quests are marked as blue. If this game gets too difficult for you, my pro's tip is that you go to the inn and have a rest, because you can use your bonus experience there and kind of level up a bit. So if it has been a while since you were at the inn and did that, you may level up quite a bit this way. Now about the combat, I think the combat is kind of chill and laid back. Now personally, I don't find the combat difficult or hard, because the game tells you gradually stuff about the combat. It doesn't throw everything at you so that you are confused from the first second. The game really tells you one thing now, and 2 hours later one more thing, and you have already gotten the hang of the first thing by that point. So just read, and it is easy to understand. A lot of people think that the combat is kind of like too complicated later in the game, but it doesn't really have to be complicated, because I have experienced, well, it's auto attacking, I have experienced that you can kind of not pay too much attention in the combat. You don't really have to pay super much attention. If you're good at grinding and sleeping at the inn and having a good high level at all points during the main story, and you're good with the aux cores, the equipment on the drivers, like the actual people, and the affinity charts, and the points things that you assign, skill points, if you're good at all that micromanaging, combat isn't hard. It really isn't. You can kind of button mash your way through this game. And if you are stuck, and I have been stuck, I really have, and I have died a lot. Like, out in the field, you can suddenly run into like a level 80 crazy person, like a creature that is way higher in level than you are, and one hit and you're dead. So you gotta pay attention when you're traveling around. If you travel around like in the open world environment and you see that the creatures are kind of high level, that means you're not supposed to be there yet, so turn back. About the graphics, I played this game first handheld mode. Like, I could see some places that some textures are old and kind of like bad. But other places in the game, like if you really look at everything in the graphics, like really look for stuff in like the cutscenes and in the corners of everything, some places look really good. Maybe they worked on those places lastly, and some places in the graphics, I got a PlayStation 2 kind of graphics feeling. You can probably maybe notice that, but it's I like that graphic. I mean, I like when it looks a little like oldish. I don't mind, as long as the gameplay is super solid, and it is. So do I recommend this game for everyone? Yes, I do. With all of my heart, I do. If you are already an RPG fan, if you enjoy RPGs, this is what it ultimately boils down to. You have to be a big RPG fan. And you will love this game because it's full of content and the humor is hilarious. I really enjoy this sort of humor. I actually giggled and kind of laughed all alone playing this game. I really enjoy some of the dialogues and the characters so far. I would say that this is the sort of dream come true kind of RPG that I have been wanting and wishing for and longing for forever. What do you think about this game? Have you picked it up? Are you planning to pick this up? Do you think it's too expensive? Well, I do not, because it is worth every single penny that you put into it. But only if you are an RPG fan, like I said. This game can easily be ticked in like 200 hours. I can see that happening. It's kind of like that sort of game. It will take you some time to complete, if you want to do everything, that is. So, anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you later. Follow my Twitter and subscribe to my channel.